ask you as a goalie, what kind of goes through your mind when you're about to go into penalty kicks?
You know, today I was just glad that I got a chance to be involved. I definitely wasn't for most of the game. It was a little bit back and forth. But I knew if these guys got me there that we could get it done together. So I mean, I don't know what goes through my mind. It's just get it done, you know?
Yeah. What did it do for you to get the block on the first one?
The first one was a good mood booster, I guess. It was a good momentum builder. Yeah. I think it lifted the guys more than anything, so just kept the ball rolling, you know?
How surprised are you when you can have a shootout and have like three of those? Because usually if teams don't score, it's because they either shot it too high or because the goalies really have a chance to really get much guessing in it. Yeah.
I mean, I'm glad to contribute anytime I can. Today was a little bit more than usual, but I mean, anytime I can help out the team, it's always a great moment.
And what's it like just to win this championship?
This is incredible. We won it my freshman year, and we haven't been back since. So to win with these guys that I've been battling with for a long time, to win with my family, means the world to me.
First, I was going to ask about the goalie scoring regulation. What kind of happened on that play?
Well, I was just kind of following the play in, and Brendan played it across. Just kind of shanked the shot. It was pretty funny.
Yeah.
But I just happened to be wide open and had like the whole net, and all I had to do was tap it in. Mm-hmm. It was really nice.
What was it like out there for both offenses to try to get anything done today? Because I know you guys had a 0-0 tie earlier this year.
Yeah, I mean, it seemed to me like they were trying to sit back and push it towards maybe one opportunity on a corner or something towards PKs. Mm-hmm. We just kept trying to push forward, and it just didn't seem like it was going to go in, but
yeah. The type of games you guys had this weekend, how will that help you next week when you get into the NCAA tournament?
I mean, definitely, especially our fitness, it's definitely helped us a lot. It was good for us to have two tough games like this, push us, show what we can do.
And as a player, I mean, obviously the goalie has a lot of pressure, but what's it like either kicking or watching the penalty kicks when that happens?
Personally, I'm actually like pretty good with getting into those. I like don't really feel too much pressure on it, so I like going last.
Yeah. What do you think it did for the team to see the first block that he made on there for sure?
Oh, it definitely lifted us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess the first thing I was going to ask you, as a person who's been a goalie coach for your whole life, are you able to like, give much help when you get to these kind of situations? Like, do you guys practice penalty shots much? Or?
No, you know what? You can never practice for for this moment, the pressure of the moment. You know, some teams do. We don't. Yes. A lot of even the professional teams that I was involved with, was the same thing. How do you recreate the pressure of that? It's on the day. Who wants to step up and take one? And you can see it in their eyes. Yeah. Who wants to take one? And Mike's a confident guy, and came up big. And you need that in the playoffs. A goalkeeper that's going to do something for you special in a moment like that.
And when you saw him like block their very first kick, did you kind of get a good feeling about how that might go for you guys?
So. Well, yeah. You know, I mean, you want to get off to a really good start in PKs, and you know, generally, if a goalkeeper can stop one, you've got a really good chance of winning it. Mm-hmm. And for him to make three is unbelievable and a testament to his talent.
Yeah. And I asked the guys, too, obviously, the way you had to win both your games this week, how will that help you guys when you get into the NCAAs next week? Because you've already been through two pretty pressure situations.
Yeah, you know what? It does. It's, you know, it makes you stronger. You know, we talk about getting 5% better every week in all areas. Where can we get better and keep going forward? And, you know, this is a huge one for us in these types of games. You know, penalty shootout, tight game yesterday in OT. It shows, I think, a real resilience in the team that's strong. So the team that beats us is going to have that as well. And hopefully we don't find one that has it.
Yeah, that's just what's it mean to the program now. You get a couple of so-called off years for you guys, at least the last couple of years, but to be back at this level, what does that mean for you?
Oh, yeah, so much. You know, it's really nice to build it the way, you know, to continue on with some of the traditions that we have here at St. Lawrence, and to see these guys take this to that next step that you know, we've become used to here at St. Lawrence, and you know, we're really excited about it, and I'm really pleased for the guys. It's all about players, and they've really put in a shift, and I'm very excited for them.
Is it ever tough for them to have like the past, you know, because they weren't around in some of those teams, but they hear about it all the time? I mean, is it ever kind of tough to be like,
you know what? I think the big thing is this, the rich history that we do have here. Can build you strength with the right kind of people, and I think these players here that get strength from that. I think, you know, I mean, it's like everything. You know, 20 years ago, we won every game 8-0, right? As it goes, you know how it is. But it's good. I don't think they shy away from it. They want to make their mark in that history and become a part of it. And when these seniors graduate, they become part of that Saint Soccer family, which is a great alumni we have.